There's a place called a gin mill way down in the slums. There's a place called a gin mill way down in the slums. My baby goes that night and stays till the morning comes.
Hey. Oh, she drinks gin. What's happening?
Hello, sorry, I was a little far away from the microphone.
Happens. Little piggy show back at Alley's.
Piggies.
And we have an old... Mel.
I just lost half.
You just said
I still
old.
Got it in one.
All right. That's all you need.
Yeah.
Take the other one off.
Of course, that's Mel from Red Remains.
Hi.
You said old.
She's having... Huh?
You said old first, though.
I was talking about you.
Oh, okay. Right. Gotcha.
I was going to say an old because this is... You guys are one of our first guests here at Alley's.
Mm-hmm.
Were you?
And, she is getting old.
Excuse you.
You were in your 20s when
the table.
This started, and now you're
whatever.
22.
Yeah.
29 and holding.
I mean, how long have you guys been doing this?
5 years now.
Okay, yeah, so I was 30. Thank you.
Oh, you were 30.
Yes.
Okay.
Barely.
All right. Well,
that makes you. Ooh, I know how to do math.
Yeah. Yeah. 35. I'm 35.
Drummers can only count to four.
Yeah. There you go. Yeah.
I was laughing because we were getting ready to come on, and you guys were coming up, and Sean came up and introduced himself to Pat, and I'm like, what?
Why are you introducing?
Why in the hell are you guys introducing? Because know each other.
It's been so long.
And he's
I wasn't here when the band was here. I was here when you were here.
Yeah.
I was like, holy shit, it's been that long.
Yeah, it has been a long. Or I was out that day or whatever.
Then I felt like I'm sure I was for not introducing him.
You should. Yeah, I would say so.
That happens all the time.
But we have with us Red Remains, Matt, Mike, Mel, and Sean. Screws up my alliteration, unfortunately. But, way to go. Change your name. Get an M in there, please.
We'll just do an M apostrophe at the beginning of it. It could be Michonne.
My
name
like
is Michonne.
I'm going to go by that. That's stage name now. No, actually, Walking Dead, we're going to go Michonne.
Oh, jeez.
I like it.
Well, it's good to have you guys, man.
Yeah. Thanks for having us here.
Yesterday, we were talking a little bit right before you guys were doing your first EP. We know we came out here, and that was 2015 or 16?
16.
2016.
Yep.
2016.
Don't say it like that.
Yeah. It's been a while.
But you guys have been busy. I mean, you guys see you guys all the time, and you guys are all busy. I mean,
not in the last year.
Well, we were.
We don't count. You know, we don't speak. We don't speak of 2020. Yeah,
exactly. Gotcha. Yeah. Yeah. Gotcha. So yes, other than that, yes.
Yeah.
The Unforsaken.
Did you guys so during the year that will not be named, did you guys try any of the Zoom recording sessions or anything where you were all just at your own houses?
No.
And try to do any of that and make it work?
No, we just focused on learning how to record ourselves, and we're still in the process of that right now. We have a bunch of songs really close to done, but not quite there.
We've been practicing for 5 years, and as you can see, I still can't get it right.
Yeah, Mel, if you can, just keep watching that, the screen, and see if you,
that button says on, that button says off.
See if the levels are okay. Gotcha. There might be a little bit of clipping going on, so we're still playing around with new microphones and some other things, too.
So where were you guys doing last year? Were you doing writing? Were you guys? I mean, some people said that it just kind of went away from everything they were doing to kind of take a break from it all. And some people got into writing.
We did a little bit of all the things. Yeah. We did take a little bit of a break. I think we took a month ish off where we didn't practice. We didn't really meet or anything. Just mostly because it's at that point there were no vaccinations. It was
nobody knew what to do. Yeah. There was a good 30. Yeah, there was a month or two where everybody shut down.
Cause
I remember having to leave and go just drive through Castleton because I live right there, and it was 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and it's fucking ghost town.
I know it was the best.
I know. Traffic was sweet.
Yeah. 5 o'clock, and I could get from one side of town to the other in 15 minutes.
I know, right?
Amazing.
Wait. I work downtown a lot. Actually found parking at every building I needed to go to.
Damn right up front. Yep.
And then we also did a little. We've done a little bit of writing. We've done a little bit of recording. We've had one show so far.
Since
a month ago. We finally did
14
one.
14 months.
And it had been 14 months since we'd been out.
So many scheduled in that middle section there that got canceled.
Yeah.
Remember the initial discussions were.
Four.
Oh. we'll wait a few months, and by June this thing will have blown over. So we just started booking shows for
end of the summer.
That had been all over the place. People, you know, we started like, it's starting to back off a little bit. Oh nope. There we go.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah, that had to be rough. It had to be really rough.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we were. It's funny that we actually had a New Year's Eve show up in Fort Wayne to play with two other bands, and it was actually going to be really good money for an original band to go up there and play.
Yeah.
And we kept going, when's the governor going to open up? When's he going to open up?
Yeah.
When's the mayor of Fort Wayne? Cancel the show.
Yeah. And that happened almost to all of the shows that we had.
Yeah.
It was a week or two out, and we're like, is this going to happen? And they're like, we don't know.
Yeah.
So it was, it was pretty short notice as well. Like, keeping your fingers crossed, hoping we can play, but.
Most of them, they were trying to hold on to some of the bookings, but then they eventually, it's just, we're not going to have enough people to pay you or to pay the people to be here to serve. And
that's the people that's really paying for all this
They don't
entertainment.
What do you do?
One of the places we were supposed to play at shut down. They didn't just cancel the show.
The week
shut
before
down.
We were supposed to play, they just notified, hey, we're done.
Yeah, it was like a week before we were supposed to play, too.
Yep.
Yeah.
I didn't see too many. A lot of bars, at least the ones I go to, made it through. I'm not sure how they made it through, but obviously a few loans and all that. But I didn't see too many bar places closed down.
Yeah.
Like, they had just enough, and then they let some of the rules for serving food and some of the other stuff. But, for a full-on skeleton crew. And they're coming back up. But I was happy to see that not a lot of them got closed. But they're all still going to struggle for another year.
I think takeout saved a lot of them.
Yeah. That was huge. There's some places that made more durian because of the takeout and stuff. Mm-hmm. It's like, what are they going to do?
Less overhead.
Do they kind of what are they going to do now? Are they going to kind of concentrate more back on that? It's odd. It's like, what does everybody do now? Obviously, this changed everything. So, you can't just get back in the group. It's never going to be the same.
Yeah.
So, what do you do? What did you guys do to start getting back together and, playing again? I mean, just kind of getting the groove back together, and that had to have been odd itself. I mean, you don't play
I complained, said I need to play drums.
But he could have gone down and done that.
Rest of the band said, you could have played it. You could have played them anyways without us.
Yeah.
How long did we actually stop rehearsing for? We stopped for a while, but then we started doing mask rehearsals.
It might have been like 6 weeks.
About 6 weeks.
It was less than 2 months, but more than one. Somewhere in there.
It was as soon as they lifted up the ban.
The travel ban.
Yep.
But then we just all wore masks, and we have a relatively large room.
Yeah.
So we all just kind of had our own little corner and.
Yep.
Stayed
it worked.
There. I mean.
Then, we didn't kill each other, so figuratively or literally. So,
tried to figure out how to record, and
we'll
see.
You guys didn't do. I guess that's where I'm getting. What do you mean you were trying to figure out how to record? Yeah,
we literally bought the equipment, the microphones, the interface.
Oh, okay. So your other EP you did somewhere else.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah, we had Fallout Productions did that one.
Like, Sean basically built a room in his basement that we turned into a recording space.
No, isn't that so nice? Look at him sacrificing his.
No, you better talk to the wife.
Yeah, I was gonna say his wife is so happy. She doesn't mind. It's not that.
No, she doesn't.
Not at all. Well, I'm sure she would have preferred it not be in her house, so she'd have to hear the drums.
If given
all
the choice,
the drums.
I'm sure.
Probably,
it's a great idea anywhere else, but here.
Probably. Here. She doesn't have to wear headphones now to watch TV while we're practicing. So.
Oh, okay.
Before he built the house, we did it in his garage at his other house.
Right.
Which was,
two
10 feet
away.
From the other room.
Oh, well, shit. But still 2 rooms away, and she had to wear wireless headphones to be able to watch TV while we were practicing. So. Yep. Never said anything.
Nope, she wouldn't.
Nope.
Was it all soundproofed and you got the...
Well, it was until our singer had to...
Oh, you hush.
Oh, what?
It was
not
soundproof.
I love drama.
So,
you know what I mean? You've got at least the... Like, even my office has the phone stuff on the walls because I have hardwood floors and box, and I'm on conference calls all the time. I had to put up crap on the walls.
We...
let me be the intermediary
here. Yes, go ahead, Matt.
We put up the room very quickly, and we're like, we want to start playing in here, so we never finished the walls.
It was just drywall.
Nailed to the studs, didn't cover the seams, didn't mud it.
Yeah.
And Mel wants it to look nice now,
I
so
do.
She took down all the soundproofing.
Because
and I did not make him do it. I said, I will do it. I will take it down.
She's been
I will
doing
put
it by
back
herself.
Up. I will paint it. I will do the mudding on the seams. I will do this. But he's still like, took down my foam panel. Why are you taking that down?
Well, you need that. Well, yeah, otherwise, you're just going to reverberate, bouncing off all the...
I'm aware, and it will go back up after we get half the room painted red.
There you go.
The better question was, why did you even put them up?
Because he knew that this was going to happen.
Exactly.
And he still put them up anyway, and I told him multiple times, don't put those up, I'm just going to take them down.
I honestly assumed we'd live with the way it was forever.
Wait, whose house is it?
His.
Mine.
Okay. We were...
It's my room now.
Right. We were just anxious to start playing.
Right.
We all just show up and go in whenever we
So Mel and I are definitely not married, but she is my little sister.
I was trying to figure it out because you said talk to the wife, but Mel's doing all the decorating, I guess, as it were.
My wife was going to come tonight, but she decided not to.
Yeah,
your work wife is here. It's okay.
Yeah, exactly. No. I go on road trips with his wife, so she's fine.
Yeah,
it's good.
She does.
Fine.
Yep.
That's good.
No,
yeah, we
her
leave him at home, and we go places.
Yeah, there you go.
She's not work wife. She has a name. What is it, Mel?
Band mom.
Oh,
no.
my wife.
No,
that's
your
yes.
wife.
Oh,
is the band mom.
What's Mel's name?
I don't know. My
Helen?
Name is Mel.
Singer.
Oh, yeah.
I thought it was Helen.
It is Helen. Yeah.
That's how she saved in my
name.
Phone.
What?
It's a stage name that we never actually used. But.
Helen Red.
Yep.
Helen Red.
There's a line in one of the first songs that we recorded. It's called Bloodshot.
Right.
And there's a line in it that says, I am hell in red. And the way I enunciate it and the way I say it, it comes out like it's saying, I'm hell in red.
Yeah, it's actually perfect.
It
works.
Yeah.
It works.
So
I
it's,
like it.
Yeah.
Go with it.
Yeah. Apparently I'm going to Michonne.
Yeah.
Yes, you are now Sean. Just so we can keep with my keeps my OCD down. I like alliteration. It's very helpful.
Yep. Well, I think I go to Mahelan, though. So that's not going to work.
No, that's not going to work at all. No, yes,
Mahelan?
Yeah, that's not
Mahelan.
Mahelan.
Melon.
Melon.
Yeah, there you go.
Would not be the first time
probably,
I was
yeah,
called
I say,
that.
It's probably, that's probably happened before.
That's not right. Shame on you.
So did you guys, being off, obviously not that long, thankfully, but did you guys come up with any other hobbies while you're in hiatus that you or getting back
gaining
to things
weight.
That you hadn't done
gaining
in a long
weight.
Time?
Yep.
I think we all get back into eating and
yeah.
Yep.
I got into cooking and taught myself how to play organ.
Organ? Really? You have an organ?
I have like a
oh okay. Gotcha.
Like a cord.
No.
Not
that. Granted, I know it's a long, lonely year, but not that organ.
He's married. It's fine.
Exactly.
Yeah, he's already known that. So.
No comment.
A pipe organ.
There you go.
That doesn't make it better.
Yes.
Hey, wait.
It doesn't make it better.
Wait, we gave you an out for Father's Day.
It's true. We're not going to talk about that. This is a family show.
What? Well, kind
I was
of.
Joking, but.
In the early times it is, yes.
My God, Sean, how quick did you drink that?
Well, sometimes you just got to get through that
Bloody
Mary.
You just drink an entire Bloody Mary in about 3 seconds.
And?
Seven.
Do you need a ride home?
Not yet.
Not yet. That's what the Bloody Marys are for,
yep.
right?
Yep.
It's good. Matt will give you a ride home then.
All right. as long as we don't have to talk about an organ.
Oh, good grief. We need more drama.
So you're gonna have an organ on the band now too? Are you working
Possibly.
It in? Possibly.
Well, we've been talking about working some more keys into some songs.
Mm-hmm. Piano, okay. organ, just in general.
Just want to have more options, more sonic options, I guess.
I gotcha. Yeah. No,
as I think I may be misspeaking for everyone, but for me, I've really been enjoying our songwriting process lately. We've been kind of going outside of our comfort zone and writing in genres that...
Yeah.
That's what I was going to ask. The last time we talked a little bit about writing, on the first show a couple of years ago. So how has that changed, that process and being a band that's, together this long? Has that whole process changed at all or evolved?
Yes, Sean. Michon.
According to Mel, I just hit things. So I'll let the guitar players and the singer answer that.
You had to put that in there?
Yeah, you had to raise your hand for that.
I'm just here to hit things.
Thank you. He just bangs things with sticks. So
the only thing that I think's really changed is with when we've only really started this is since we didn't practice as often together, we would send each other song ideas and work on them separately instead of working it out in the same room at the same time and be like, Mike, here's a song idea. Come up with a guitar part, change stuff, and he'd send back something. And
It went a little really more digital than in person.
Hasn't that kind of changes the flow of songwriting? I don't know if it's better or worse, but it's different.
That's what I'm gonna say. Sure. I mean, sometimes you find out, hey, this is actually kind of works better, or I miss the way we, you know, being able to get together and do it. So,
yeah, I have a tendency to write two different ways. Like sometimes I like to just like sit and actually work ideas out. Sometimes like I have an idea on what I want to do and I just don't have the ability to do it at the time.
Right.
And then there's other times where, well, last practice we just sat down and just started playing. You recorded on your phone. Mm-hmm. And
those are my favorites.
It will end up being a song. I'm sure at some
eventually.
Point.
Eventually. Yeah. Awesome. That's how I think quite a few of our songs started, where, you know, Matt or Mike will just, you know, he'll be setting his levels on his amp, so he just starts playing, you know, just
something,
a riff.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden, Sean's in there with a drum beat, just like, oh, we like that. And so he'll just throw something in it, and then he's like, I got something for that. So my job is I sit there and I just record it so that we can have it. And
So I don't know how many
song
ideas. I'm
not that quick at writing, so.
I don't know how many song ideas we've lost because nobody was recording it.
Was ever, like, yeah.
Hey, what did you just do there?
I'll remember.
I have no idea.
Or I'll remember it next week.
Yeah. Just remember that. Yeah. Come back to it. Yeah, no, that never works.
But no, we've made it a habit for years to record, even if it's just most of the time it's Mel grabs her phone and just records the idea through her phone, and we save it in the cloud. And just last week, Mike pulled one down that we'd recorded like 2 or 3 years ago. He's like, I like this riff. Let's do something with it. So that's the song we're working on, a riff that I wrote dicking around at rehearsal for like 3 years ago. So
go back and listen to stuff and hey, if there's anything with that one, well,
it's awesome. I'm always fascinated by that because it goes completely. I can never figure out how to do that. I'm a project manager and an IT nerd and all that, but I can never figure out how you guys put that together. So it's always fascinating to me to try to see if I can understand it. I still never do. I don't know how you just come up with a song and then try to find the music to it and then just a guitar riff and then the guy comes in and just bangs on stuff and adds a beat to it. So
I don't think any band I've ever been in has had one way they do it too. Sometimes we'll write a whole song. We'll spend 2 weeks, multiple hours working on it and somebody will just be forward and say, I'm unhappy with this. I don't like it. Well, what don't you like? Well, I don't like the lyrics. Okay, pull the lyrics off, throw them away. Don't throw them away. Put them in storage. Mm-hmm. Let's write new lyrics. Or I don't like the guitar part. Cool. Or I don't like the verse.
Yeah.
We take that chunk and we throw it away or put it in storage and then put something else in. And the fun part of that is sometimes it'll be a year later. We'll write a new song. Hey, I think those lyrics that we took out of that other song a year ago would be great for this.
Yeah.
Pull it out. Song's done.
The song that we're writing right now, I was getting my notepad out to start working on lyrics while they were playing it.
Yeah.
And I found lyrics already written that I don't even remember writing them. But they're in my handwriting, so I'm assuming that I
sure
wrote them.
Sure, I did it. I have a lot of text messages like that.
Yeah, like they they had to have been at some point. But I was like, I think this fits. I mean, I had to change a couple little things around, but their song written.
Awesome.
I mean, it's, you know, stuff like that, or, you know, we'll have a song that we're no longer going to play anymore, so I can pull some lyrics that I really like from that, or even pull guitar parts, or there's just so many different ways to create
something. I think that would be a big advantage, too, a band that stays together and be able to, you know, remember that stuff. But, hey, remember that one lick you did back then, or the lyrics, and you think about that stuff down the road.
That's why we record it all.
Yeah.
So we have
a disgusting amount of recordings in our OneDrive.
Yeah. Well, and even as unsigned bands and things of that nature, you just hit on something that made me think about something. You know, in this day and age, I told you guys the other day my definition of being in a band. I'll tell you in just a second. But in this day and age, keeping four people together for 5 years.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And even in famous bands, that doesn't happen.
It doesn't,
like that.
Even locally, you don't see that very often. A lot, I mean, people have things to go on. I mean, you know, things change, so it is. Yeah. It's hard to keep, you know, you know, it's even for us, we've changed a lot over the last couple of years just doing this. It's just like, because people's lives change and things come and go, and so it's you know, it's unique, and it's hard to keep that same core together.
Which I'm not sure if that's good or bad, that you and I are the only ones that don't have a life that this is what we have to do.
I didn't say that. No, I didn't want to go ahead. I didn't want
to
make this a sad
show. You get to drink
right?
beer and talk to people. That sounds amazing
to me. We have like five guys, but only like him and I are the ones who can regularly do it. So is that sad? Or
it's great that you two had all the time in the world to go out and drink beer and talk to people every day. You know? Hey, thanks.
I work from home. So
do I.
I'm sure there's a lot. There are a lot of people that are jealous of that.
Oh yeah,
My husband comes home and I'm like, "Hey, what are you doing? What did you do today? How was your day?
You want to go? You want to go somewhere? You want to go somewhere? Where do you want to go?
I'm at home with the dogs and cats all day."
So yes, my definition of a band is dating three other people and asking them where they want to go to dinner.
That's what it's like half the time.
That's what being a band is like. So,
yeah, but they all know about each other.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Unfortunately, I don't know. Mel's quirks. Yeah.
So you're sister wives.
I've been.
It's sure.
I've been in bands before where you don't even like each other from the beginning, and you know it's destined that some fallout is going to happen. I don't speak for anybody else here. I won't pretend to. I assume based on how I feel, I've never had any real hard feelings about anyone in this band. Yeah.
Well, Matt, we need to have a talk on Sunday.
That's fine.
Speaking of that, since you brought it up,
made this really easy. Thanks.
Yeah. No, we argue. We have just like any family.
Well, yeah.
But
if you don't
know,
that's an issue too, because that means you don't trust
each
other.
At the end of the day, it's a shut the hell up. Just
Well, we've never had any bad arguments, we've had disagreements and stuff like that. But what'd you go have?
We try to have regular.
No. I think that I've probably only lost my cool in this band once, but
and we know how that turned out.
And
or was that in the last band technically?
Oh, I guess that was.
No.
Oh, no, you're talking about this one.
Yeah,
oh, you did.
That's why I was trying not to go there.
Remember that one time where I.
At band camp?
I got mad and I just put my guitar up and just said, "I'm going home."
Yeah.
No, I don't actually.
I do.
Was I there?
Yeah. So it was your fault.
You were there. Okay. So good that I remember exactly why he was upset. Totally.
I don't even remember this.
Yours is right in front of you.
Oh. I assume I didn't prepare for something I was supposed to prepare for, knowing myself.
We were trying to work on something and you were paying no attention to what was going on. You kept playing like while I was trying
I remember it now. Yep.
And I was in a bad mood. So
I have a tendency to diddle when everybody's talking.
On your organ.
at full volume while we're trying to have a conversation about
my full bass stack at concert volume. I'm like just jacking around. But to be fair, that's how I write most of the song ideas that we have. It's like dicking around when everybody else is talking.
Got to justify.
I'm bargaining.
He's trying to create theme music to the argument. It's like, that's good. Yeah.
Like Jaws style.
Creating tension, yes.
But he is correct, though. He is correct, though, because usually we're having a conversation. He's over there going,
I've been trying to turn it down lately when I do it.
Yes, you've been.
Well, no. I just get on the microphone. I'm like, Matt, stop.
And then I roll the volume down to 2.
Yeah. And then he keeps going.
Just put some headphones on and hook it into some headphones. Just play to yourself.
But I was giving him props because he is correct. Because after you told him to turn it down, he'd be like, hold on, record this.
Yeah. That's true. Nice. All right. What are we drinking here? What is
so it is a beer show.
It smells apple cider vinegar.
It tastes like, I get vinegar all the way. This is from Three Floyds. This is their Pear Bear Sour.
It's a wild ale.
And
it's a wild ale.
Yeah. And
I love vinegar.
I'm not sure that's supposed to be.
My mouth is literally watering right now.
Beer's not usually supposed to smell like vinegar.
Exactly.
I don't know if this is going to pair well with this old fashioned.
Yeah, it'll be great.
Yeah. Yeah, I tried it. I'm like, holy shit, that tastes like straight up vinegar.
It does?
Really? To me, it does.
Oh. Yeah, it does.
But I love vinegar. I'm like, I don't know if this is right. It may be a bad beer, but man, this is really good.
I don't know.
I'm with you.
I don't think I could drink a whole one of those.
No.
It would be literally like just drinking
if
a bottle
of vinegar. If I get heartburn,
go
get a Three Floyds Pear Bear.
Yeah, exactly.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
You know what doesn't go great with? Fucking Long John Silvers.
Yeah, absolutely. Yep. With cod.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah, a little fried fish.
Mm-hmm. You know, because, yeah, you put that, you know, you always put the vinegar all over the.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that one closed down. But speaking of things, speaking of Long John Silvers, they closed down.
A lot of them did.
A lot of them did.
Yeah.
The one in Anderson did, too.
The one in Castleton
did. That is tart.
Yep.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. That is a very, very vinegary wild ale.
I'm not sure how I feel about it.
Yeah, I don't get pear in that at all.
No, that's I don't know. This is just a
vinegar sour.
Something went wrong here, and goddamn,
well,
like vinegar tastes
someone's
good.
It's Three Floyds, so it probably didn't go wrong, or they wouldn't have put it out.
I just can't believe how much vinegar comes.
It is American style wild ale brewed with pears. There are pears in it, but Three Floyds says it's got notes of pear, bubble gum.
Mm. Nope. Not even close.
All I tasted was pear and vinegar.
Yeah. I see. After a couple of drinks, I start to get a little bit of pear starts coming through, but it's so that vinegar is so
and
heavy.
And oak with lots of funk.
There's a lot of funk.
They used Brett and lacto. So they used Brett and lacto for that. Which is a little odd. The artwork's pretty cool.
There's something else in there that I can't.
Hold on. Time out.
Bubblegum.
Time out. I know we're on a podcast about beer. But he just went like way up here. Maybe you understand it because you used to be in this industry.
Those the hops or the malts?
That's the yeast dish.
I knew it was one of those things to funk it up.
I'm just saying you went way up here with your above.
Ah, I did not know that. Well, yeah.
I play drums. You have to use
small words for Michonne.
Hold on.
Remember,
Michonne played drums.
Michonne's favorite beer is the one in front of him. He doesn't care which one it is.
This is correct. But I was going to be.
Yeah, it's a so
not so nice to our host and say, play me a paradiddle.
Yeah. because
you were way up here on.
I get you. Yeah, and I apologize. So there's all kinds of different hops for the beer. There's all kinds of different yeast you can use as well.
Yeah.
And there are standard yeast called Brettanomyces and then the lactobacillus.
That's what you were talking about.
The Brettanomyces. Right. Those are used to particularly funk something up without actually making it a sour. Because there's different ways to sour, or you can kind of almost. I don't call it. I guess it fake a sour.
I don't know if it's. Yeah,
but it's not as dangerous because when you companies that do sour beers, you really the real like straight up sour stuff. They usually have to go and do all that in a entirely other building from where their regular beer is done because it can then contaminate
everything.
Oh, I gotcha.
Yeah. Because it's meant to. Those particular yeasts are meant to make it funky. And it's usually a much more cidery or fruity type beer for the sours and the wild ales. They're really fruit heavy, is what they're for, and they're light. And I'm a big fan of sours
when they're done right. Yeah,
yeah, when they're done right. And this is good, but that vinegar. Woo.
Yeah, to me, it's like a shot of vinegar with a splash of something.
It's a malt vinegar.
Yeah, I mean, it's more of a farmhouse than a sour, I think, because of the Brett.
Well, it is calling it a wild ale, so it's not really. Yeah, it's in the sour category, but it's on the wild ale side. So, but still, I like it. It's still pretty good.
Yeah, I definitely want some fried fish now.
Yeah,
it goes well with this
common
necessity.
That probably doesn't go well at all.
I think if you're eating anything salty.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It would help mellow it.
Potato chips or
French fries.
Yep. Yeah.
Yep.
French fries. Oh, yeah.
That'd
be great.
Sean, try it.
You might actually be able to, like, dip your French fries in that.
It's got a little chocolatey coffee type.
We do have about the size of the little cup you would get at Long John Silver's, you know, to put all the.
Right.
Yeah.
Long John Silver's is not an official sponsor.
They're closed. It don't matter. I remember reading one time, I think it was their super platter, you know, you could get. Was rated like the highest calorie meal available from all fast food.
They just take the whole thing and dump it in the batter.
Yeah,
and it's fish.
Yeah. It was like the super platter. It was like the fish, chicken, shrimp, and the hush puppies, the fries, and all the crinkle and all the crumbling.
I mean,
I think they did give you coleslaw for the illusion of health.
Right, exactly. Yes, yes.
For your vegetables.
Their coleslaw was the shit, though.
Yeah.
Their coleslaw.
Yeah.
Did you ever put the crumbles of the fry batter in the coleslaw?
Oh, yeah.
That's the way to go.
Absolutely. Yes.
I remember growing up, my parents would, like, ask for, and this is why I'm the size, the shape I am, probably, but, like, you used to be able to, like, ask for extra crumbles.
Oh, yeah, extra crunchies, yeah.
They wouldn't do that anymore.
Now they charge, well, you can get it, but they charge you for it.
Yeah,
you get paid, like, 50
them,
cents or something.
Yeah.
This is quickly turning into a Long John Silver's podcast.
I don't know why they just didn't sell that, you know, can I get a box of crumbles, you know, instead
pretty
of.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Maybe you better go find out if they'll sponsor you.
Just dump the batter into the fryer.
There you go. Hell yeah.
Hey, if you're not going to find out if they'll sponsor you, we're going to find out if they'll sponsor us.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Who doesn't, you know, everybody, it's a guilty
pleasure.
I'll
wear a yellow slicker on stage.
I don't know anybody who didn't like Long John Silver's. It was just a guilty pleasure. You just couldn't eat it all the time because, it's awful. Oh, he didn't like Long John? Nope, not even the chicken?
No, me either.
Oh, I don't think I ever had the chicken.
Well, then
it tasted just like the fish, but other than that, it was really good.
Yeah, it all tasted the same. It was just different consistency.
And they went to sponsorship.
It's like going to a hibachi. It just all tastes soy. It all tastes the same.
Yeah. Oh, it's delicious. Oh, that one's good, too.
Tastes like chicken.
I can't tell if the fish tastes like chicken or the chicken tastes like fish.
Or grease. It all tastes like grease. Man.
Moving on from Long John Silver's.
I got nothing.
This podcast is brought to you by...
Not Long John's.
Not Long John Silver's.
Allie's Alehouse.
Yeah.
Long John Silver is like one of those places that after I always felt dirty.
Right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And it was guilty. Yeah. Right. It was a guilty pleasure.
It's like the glory hole of fast food restaurants.
I know. It's like I need to find a way to shower my insides.
You know that's the... That's a letter of the law if Mike talks about it.
Yeah.
So what is one of your guilty favorite restaurants? Or, you know, your guilty treats?
McDonald's.
Really? That's it?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I figured something different.
Are we talking like calorie count or
money?
Hold on.
Back up to the drummer.
Okay.
Jesus.
I will eat there 3 times a day, 7 days a week. So there you go.
Right. Wait, hold on. That's not a guilty treat.
There's no
Monday.
He said he would. He didn't say he does.
There's no guilt.
Guilty.
If he did that, his insides would be gelatin by now.
Guilty treat.
Yeah. No, they would be pickled and
guilty
just be preserved forever.
Well, I mean, I don't know. It's like, you know, I mean, like...
A place you like, but you don't go to very often because you know it's bad for you.
Yeah, like Cinnabon. like a big...
McDonald's?
There you go.
No.
Yeah, Cinnabon, big giant, yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, that's
nasty.
I'll go with Cinnabon.
All right.
Yeah. That works. Mike.
Thanks, guitar player.
I wouldn't do it.
I think mine is, and I know it's, but I just can't go very often, Dairy Queen.
Yeah.
And a big giant.
Yes. I was going to say Dairy Queen
Blizzard
before
or whatever, you know.
Yeah.
And then some other stuff, you know. Somewhere you just feel like, you know, yeah, this is not going to go well.
You know you should feel guilty for eating at a place that serves their chicken tenders with gravy instead of a dipping sauce.
Wow, you are correct. Never thought about it.
And that is my guilty fast food pleasure is the gravy.
Gravy.
the gravy.
Dairy Queen gravy?
Yes.
Really? Not even KFC gravy?
No, so you order their chicken tenders and it comes with gravy instead of a normal dipping sauce.
Like, it doesn't have ranch or barbecue.
It's
I mean, you can get
a big
that.
Cup of gravy.
But it automatically comes with gravy unless you say otherwise.
Uh-oh.
I did not know that.
Yeah.
Well,
it's not there anymore,
but growing up, we only had one fast food restaurant in my hometown, Dairy Queen, and that was the thing I liked, so it's kind of like a nostalgia thing, too.
That makes sense, yeah.
He grew up in Amish country, and, you know.
Brendan, what's yours?
Probably the sliders. I mean,
I can't put them away.
Yeah, it's, you know,
White Castle.
Oh yeah,
3 o'clock in the morning. Oh, White Castle.
Oh, that's
I don't
the best
care
thing
what
on the planet.
Their breakfast sandwiches
are delicious.
Amazing.
I keep talking about that. Nobody knows about their breakfast.
I know. They're the best.
So
and they made
their
order.
That's real. True.
Like it's an actual
it's
egg.
Crack an egg.
Yeah. There's nothing better out there for
crack. Try that tomorrow, Sammy.
It's so good. I hate White Castle.
All that being said, though, don't expect to get through the line the same speed you would through McDonald's. They're making it right then. It's going to be a
wait. Wait.
And then you can get tater tots for the your like breakfast potato. Yep. It's tater tots. And it's amazing.
I was just going to ask what McDonald's have you been through lately? Because I've been sitting in line forever lately at McDonald's.
Yeah, because they don't have any workers. But that's a different subject.
Okay, all right. I'll shut up.
But yeah, so it is. It's a real egg that they actually. Yeah. And it's nice to see. Yeah, it does take a little bit of time, but it's a much better.
Yeah, it's not a yellow form thing on a bun.
Yeah, that they slice off a roll.
Yeah.
Egg product. Doesn't say egg product on it.
But they really don't advertise about that or anything, which is nice.
So a lot of people
think, I don't know if maybe that's why, because they don't want because they probably couldn't do it anymore.
It's a cult thing now.
Yeah.
I got confused and stopped at Taco Bell last week, and I got to the drive-thru, and it just kind of confused me because I never understand why, but he's like, comes over the thing, before I ask your order, just to notify you, we can't take orders over $10. And it just,
what?
It's happened to me twice at the Taco Bell. They won't take orders over $10 at the one down 82nd. I don't know if it's a time of day. I don't know if they only got like one guy working in the back.
So it has to be a small order to keep people
going
through.
But it makes my brain hurt because I'm just like.
Trying to do math was you're ordering?
And I'm like, why don't you want more of my money?
Well, and then it's like, all right, well, I'm going to make three orders.
I'm going to say, I got six orders.
I'm going to suggest a hypothesis here. As someone who has worked in retail before, a lot of places will have a threshold where the credit card machine doesn't check, so it's faster.
Yeah.
So it might be $10, and their credit card machine might be messed up, so it just declines everything that it checks. So if it's under $10... It's going
to
go through.
Go.
I guess. The only thing I was thinking was they only had one guy and they had limited supplies. But then at that point, I'd be like, well, just use them all up and close the doors.
Yeah.
You are correct.
But I'm sensible like that. But it was just I just thought it was the weirdest thing I'd ever heard. Yeah. Usually they're like, you got to have a minimum order of $5
right.
or something. Yeah. I've never been given a maximum price of what I can order. I'm like, well, goddammit, I want the goddamn taco pack.
Maybe it was just
I want
dude.
Two of them.
Maybe there's no manager. That guy's like, fuck this. I can't take any order over $10.
But it's happened twice.
Yeah, you said it's morning, right?
Well, it could be that maybe there's only two people working.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
if they have to make a $30 order,
right.
it's going to take them 20 years.
Yeah.
That was the only thing I could think of.
It's easier than, you know, to keep people moving.
Yeah.
So,
that was the only thing I could think of.
Maybe as a whole, but...
So just go inside next time and say, I want $30
worth.
You
know what I would do? I would find 10 of the cheapest things on the menu.
Yeah.
And I can make all of
also
them. Just to fuck them, you know?
And then change them up, everything without this. And then,
he still ordered 10 things, the $10 minimum. Yeah.
Can I get a bean burrito without the beans? And just put
I need the, I need the beefy.
Special order
everything. I need the beefy cheese burrito without cheese. Or beef.
Wow.
Double meat, add beans, add tomatoes.
Yeah.
Just add everything.
I didn't know our guitarist was such a...
Dick?
Yeah.
What band have you been in?
Say we knew that.
I told you that I'm a dick.
Does Angela know?
He's just quietly subtle about it. He's just very...
What I do is I just keep to myself until the right moment. And
so,
then
he's strategic.
So,
I am.
All right, so... I've known Michael for 17
math
years.
Did you just have
17?
To take your shoes off?
17. That'd be 21, Mel.
You have 11 toes.
Mel has a look of disgust and does not get the joke.
I get the
joke. No, she gets the joke.
I said his shoes, not his pants.
Why do you think there's a pedal right between his legs?
So I've known Mike for 17 years, and I have actually seen him angry. And I've been in three bands with him. Four times.
Really?
Five.
Not that he doesn't
you don't
get
have to
angry.
Be angry,
he just doesn't
angry.
Express
so,
it.
So three of them were at his brother.
That's the scary part when you don't express it.
Because
then you know he's plotting and planning.
Yeah. The other time was the previous
something
version.
Something bad's going to happen to you, but it's not going to be, it's just going to be subtle.
So the original version was the other time. Yeah. And then the last time he talked about with Matt. So, three times at his brother, because he used to be in, we had a band with his brother. Back in the day.
Yeah,
so
I used to live with
said
brother.
Back when I was
still
in high school.
Said brother.
And, we lived together. Yeah. So, and we practiced 2 days a week.
Yep.
Because, we were like hardcore back then.
Yep.
And
look where it got us.
Yeah.
Before and, wives and girlfriends.
So, we would practice on, what was it, Thursday, I think it was?
Tuesday and Thursday.
Yeah, no, Thursday and Sunday.
Thursday and Sunday, you're right.
And, so then, we would get into it over, writing a song because I was a dick. And, I was very bullheaded back then, and it was I didn't,
How are you going to be the next Godsmack if you didn't have
right,
that?
Right,
that is correct.
I didn't write that guitar for you to play. But anyway.
Don't play what I don't tell you to play, brother.
But, yeah, so we would get into it, though, we wouldn't actually talk to each other until next band practice.
And they lived in the same house.
Yeah, we lived in the same house. We'd pass each other. Oh, and we worked together.
Oh, that's right. I forgot.
Is that when you worked for the construction?
Yep.
Yep.
Oh. Yep.
No.
Yeah. So sometimes we'd just go to different jobs, or we would just show up at different times. We just wouldn't talk to each other.
You already grew up together. You guys, yeah. Right. Yeah. Screw that.
Nope. Yeah, so now he lives in Florida. Mike lives here. And they don't play in a band together.
No. Yeah, not too many of the family bands stick together too long.
No, not usually. You've already spent enough time and years together. That's always got to be hard.
Where's Hanson?
They're still together.
They're running the music at a church in Oklahoma.
Jonas Brothers.
Jonas Brothers. Yeah. Yeah.
My wife is a huge Hanson fan and sees them every time they come through.
Are you shitting me?
I'm telling you the truth.
I didn't know they had fans. I mean, they had one song and maybe one album, right?
They had fans, but they were like 12. They were 12 years old.
They're still releasing them.
Now they're 30.
Still releasing them.
Hold on. You said he grew up in an Amish country, so was your wife 12?
No, and they were joking. I did not grow up Amish.
I know.
I mean, you do have a nice beard.
I'm just kidding. Yeah, but he's got a mustache, so he can't be. Yeah.
You do have a pretty.
You're done.
That's what happened.
Hey, there you go. All right.
I have it too.
I haven't been grooming it because I've been wearing a mask for the last year and a half.
Yeah, yes.
And I went. This week was the first week at work where I didn't have to wear a mask, and I went in on Monday, and I'm in the bathroom, and I see myself in the mirror. I'm like,
oh,
I really need to even that thing up. I still haven't done it. But
right. And then I put my mask back on.
Yep.
Yeah, put my mask back on. Nobody knows.
Exactly. All right, I think you're getting a quick break.
We're going to chill out, and then we'll be right back.
Talk a bit more about the band.
Talk about the band and what you got coming up. All right.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. Hi, this is Mel from Allie's Alehouse. Come check us out for the best local and craft beer selection in Hamilton County and the most amazing craft food on the north side. You can check us out on Facebook or on our website, bulletpinheads.com.
Blind Pig Confessions is the greatest podcast there ever was. My name is Dave Smiley from WZPL, and if you don't listen to this show, you're dumb.
Hey.
I love your intros. Your intros are so... amazing.
I know, he points, I'm like, let's just go.
How long did it take you to write that?
Actually, longer than you would think. Yeah. All right. And I'm a writer.
Is it like a catchphrase? You just open every show with that same thing?
Well, usually our catchphrase guy hasn't been here in a while, so we didn't come up with any good ones. So, which is odd, like I said, because he is a writer, and he writes all kinds of stuff, and stuff for some magazines and all that, but that's all he comes up with. It's great.
Yeah. I don't
keep it simple.
Want this shit to be real. So.
Hold on, let me turn up the volume so you can hear my eyes roll.
Hold on.
You know they're going to use
Luckily,
that
I edit
now,
too, so
right?
I get to edit that shit
they're
out.
They're going
to
use that.
And back with Red Remains. The Alehouse. <Alehouse. laughs>
Wait, eye roll?
There you go. All right, so we're going to bring it back to you guys. What's coming up for Red Remains, and what do you got going on? Anything coming up?
We have shows.
You have shows?
We do have shows.
Get a little close to that mic for me, Mike.
Oh, sorry.
Mike, meet Mike.
Sorry, I slouch.
It's okay.
So I slouch away from the
microphone. I have to get a longer set of mics.
Or I can just scoot up. That's awkward. Stop it.
Get your hands off that.
We're determined to get Mike mad this segment. So
I told you.
Next time it happens, I'll try to get a video 17? Or audio or
yeah.
something.
18. Yeah. Actually, I was wrong. That, 18 that, years, five times.
Yeah. That's what you put on Facebook
but,
Live.
Yeah.
But he's not going to get
flip
mad.
Tables.
He's not going to get mad. He's going to plot and scheme. He might get upset, but he's going to quietly let it
So next time they come, they're like, you guys got a new drummer.
No, we can't. We practice in his house, remember?
The band already has a standing agreement with my wife that if we get divorced.
I think that you misunderstood that statement. You didn't get fired. You died in that scenario.
Oh, okay.
Is it because he's old?
I killed you.
He could still be under the house.
Gotcha. I'm old.
We have an agreement with his wife that if they ever get divorced, she gets to keep the house in the band room, and we still get to use the band room.
I think she likes you more than me.
I guarantee it. Guarantee it.
Yeah. I'll edit that out just in case anything does happen.
There's no proof. Yeah.
I mean, it's probably not even close.
So I will say there is a lot more insurance on me than her.
Right. Yeah. I wouldn't say that out loud.
So what you're saying is I would be doing her a favor. Got it.
Right?
Could be.
So that's what's in store for Red Remains in the future.
Murder?
sorry if there's a whole lot of background noise. They decided to turn up the DJ music or whatever it is all of a sudden. That got weird.
Do you want me to go? No,
it's all right. I think it'll be fine.
Yeah, we good.
Sure. I can't hear anything but the disco music. You want me to dance?
Yeah.
Wait, we want Mel to dance.
Oh,
no, we don't.
Dancer.
We do not.
There's no video, so there'll be no evidence
of me dancing.
So anyways, back to topic. We have a show coming up July 31st.
Yes.
Okay. At That Place Bar and Grill down on County Line Road, South Indianapolis, which that's like good for South because we never go South.
That's awesome.
Yeah. So, well, not anymore.
Well, I do. But,
oh,
but anyways, we are splitting the bill with a very good band.
My mom lives South. I just...
Definitely I didn't that out.
Yeah. I don't know what you guys are talking about.
Some Game of Thrones stuff up in here.
We are splitting the bill with a band called Rough House.
Okay.
Yep.
Good, very good band.
Yep.
Got a couple good female singers, and come out and listen to us.
Yep. Yeah.
July 31st starts no cover. Starts at, I believe, 9 o'clock.
Yeah. Point your microphone at your shirt so they can see
okay.
it.
Okay. Here we go. Here.
Yeah. There we go.
Plug the social media so they can know where to look.
Yeah. Alcohol.
So that's really this is the first kind of kickoff show for you guys since the whole pandemic. And
yeah, we played one small show.
Someone tried to die a few songs.
Yeah,
and,
yeah,
it really killed the set.
And it killed. And they cut our set because somebody tried to die.
Well,
so.
We cut our set. So
because we thought it would be rude to be playing while someone was dying.
Yeah,
he lived to our knowledge.
He did. So we were playing the show, and it was an outdoor show, and we got about, three, four songs in to an eight or nine
song.
We were almost halfway through the set, and a gentleman and his girlfriend sitting off, to the side of the stage, and
kind of out of the focus of everybody, because they were way off the side by themselves.
Just passed out, and I'm up on stage, and I can see him, and she starts freaking out. So his wife and his mother was a nurse and his wife is a nurse. And so I'm pointing at them and then pointing at him and I don't know what to do. I'm singing while I'm doing this.
Yeah.
And I'm playing and I'm like, what's going on?
So they finally are like, oh shit, somebody. And, and then two other people in the crowd see me doing this and rush over there. So now they've got plenty of medical people.
Right.
You end up having a seizure, didn't they?
Yeah.
Without a seizure.
Yeah, something like that. So we stopped playing.
History of epilepsy.
Called an ambulance, got him taken care of. But by the time all of that was done, our set time was over.
Oh, yeah.
And
yeah.
it was an evening show outdoors, so there's a time limit.
It was a hard stop because it was near residential area.
So the band after us, they were like, finish your set, go for it. And I was like, if we do that, your set's going to be shorter than their set.
Yeah, they're from out of town.
So we played one more song. We got back on stage, and I think we played Paint It Black by the Rolling Stones.
Rolling Stones.
Did that
one. One of our covers.
Yeah. No, we wrote it.
I don't see any damn money coming in from that song, man. I couldn't think of the right word, but money.
Royalties?
Royalties. There we go.
So, yeah, it was a good show.
Plays the drums.
Like, everything other than that.
Well, yeah.
But you guys can use that for your neck, hey, come on, something until they're first. They killed it the last show.
Yeah.
Almost.
Almost. We knock them out.
Yeah. So, yeah, that was our first show back in 14 months, and we played five songs, and someone almost died.
If that person is listening, I hope you're doing well.
Yes.
We have no ill will towards you.
And if it's something that we did, we're sorry.
Yeah. Sorry.
If it was Mel's vocal hitting that brown note.
I was going to say, every once in a while, they'd be like, oh, that's a note.
So that's an actual thing, because... Yeah. The PA, in the enclosed area, sometimes she'll hit, a note that hits me just right, and, I get dizzy.
Yeah, it's happened a handful of times.
I think it's,
over the
resonant frequency of the room or whatever.
Yeah.
I just want to point out, it's not necessarily a bad note.
Yeah.
Correct.
Right. Just saying. Yeah.
Because our singer doesn't hit bad notes.
Oh, bullshit.
Going back to going back to plugging things.
Yes.
Someone who remembers things better than I do, plug the socials so people know where to go to look for upcoming shows.
Oh, we are on Facebook, obviously.
Yep.
Red Remains. We are on Instagram at Red Remains. We are on Twitter at Red Remains.
And we have a website.
And we have a website at redremains.net.
There you go.
There you go.
Beauty. .com.
No, it's not dot .com anymore, is it?
It never was.
No.
.net.
We don't have that. We don't have dot .com money.
Yeah. No.
This is correct.
We barely have dot .net money.
Is dot .net money, is dot .net cheaper?
Usually. Oh, yeah.
Really?
Oh,
yeah.
It's less desirable.
Yeah. I did not know that.
If you go try to get redremains.com right now, it's pretty high.
Oh, yeah. That's ridiculous. I didn't think it was
available. Somebody bought it. Somebody bought it and they see that we have a band.
There are whole air quotes companies that exist.
Yeah.
Just buying domains and trying to ransom them essentially.
Yeah, I've seen that. There's even a service like some of mine ones that I've held on to for a while just from things I've done over the years.
Right.
You know, you can sell them or how much they might be worth, and you can put them up on auction or whatever. You know, it's like,
yep.
Nah, all right.
So here's the funny thing about search engines or whatever watching what we do. The previous version of this band, I was sitting looking at the band name on a Tuesday night. Wednesday morning, I said, I'm going to buy it. Went back. Somebody had bought it and already had it up for auction for $1,000.
They watch what people are searching
for.
They can
see the search results, the search metrics.
Yep. So,
you got people that tell
so if you
doing.
If you have a good idea for a band name, buy it right away.
If it's obscure, you can probably get it for like $15. Buy the .com, the .net, all of them. Just sit on them.
Yeah. I looked about a few months ago, and I think redremains.com was sitting about $2,000.
No, thanks.
We ain't got that kind of money.
No. Not until somebody else pays attention to us besides us.
And
the blind pigs.
They come on and see the show and get us our
We usually have two fans that come to shows.
Yeah, we got a few. My wife.
I mean, outside of blood.
I wonder if our .net, I haven't even looked up if our .net and any of the others are available. I mean, we do have a .com.
Yeah.
So, you know. But we got it early in the
I was going to say, you didn't look at it and wait.
No.
9 hours.
I did have to try a few different things to get to make sure. Yeah, because I did have to try a few different names because I had. Because it was a pain.
Well, getting your Twitter handle was annoying because we couldn't use the whole thing on that. That was already taken for some reason. So it's just Blind Pig Confess. But it's a little weird. Well, Blind Pig was, because.
Blind Pig, it took a little while.
We've got a Twitter. We just don't tweet.
We don't either.
Well, we tweet out the show, but that's about it. No one pays attention.
No one cares.
Just his Instagram. Instagram.
Yeah, they don't.
Oh, come on. Well, you just you got to be active in it. That's the hard part.
You got to do every day. You got to do something. You got to.
Turn on search engine optimization.
I'm just
going to
start posting pictures of my dog. Like no caption, anything, just on our Instagram.
Just make sure.
He has his own Instagram.
That gets you a lot of likes.
You can send messages back and forth.
Oh, there you go. Matt could post pictures of his organ.
That's correct.
I'm pretty sure that's against their terms of service.
Yeah.
There we go.
Can we tell this gentleman is in IT also?
All right, well, let's get another beer going, and we're going to try one last beer for our show and see what you guys think. This is not a sour. This is a Russian Imperial Stout.
And it smells wonderful.
It smells beautiful. It smells like candy.
It's definitely a standard in the stout world and in the old Rasputin from North Coast. It's just an amazing Imperial.
That's tasty.
Isn't it? No, it's just beautiful stuff.
Oh, that's got some coffee in there.
Oh, yeah. You got a nice roasted.
More like almost an espresso-esque, not even just coffee, like espresso. A real strong.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah, super nice, roasted, toasty, and just get the nice bitter back into it.
It's amazing, the beers nowadays. What did we grow up with?
What
Budweiser,
you still drink?
Miller, and Miller High Life, and BBR.
I remember drinking Guinness. Everyone's like, "Oh my God, what's that was so odd." That's
right,
off 20 years, drinking just that. If you weren't Irish, it was like, "Oh, that's oil stuff." And now it's just it's like water.
Everyone thought you were pretentious if you didn't drink one of the three or four American
beers.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy.
Just amazing.
And now, if you drink that, they're like, "You're a little white trash."
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, in a place like this where there's, you know, yeah, 40 beers.
Do I got to up my game at band practice?
No, no. Blue Moon is acceptable.
You're in a Blue Moon. You're not, yeah. Right. I mean, you're not drinking a Schlitz or
No, he but, drinks Coors Light.
But I drink Coors Light at band practice.
That's fine. Yeah, but that's cheap.
Natural ice.
But I sweat it out. See, right. You know, so yeah.
That's cheap, yeah. And it goes a long way.
Yeah.
Is it weird that a beer pairs well with another beer?
Yes. No, it's perfect. I love that.
Oh, my God.
You're running that with your peanut butter?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So are you saying we got chocolate in your peanut butter and you got peanut butter in your chocolate?
Yeah. Yeah.
He just invented the Reese's beer?
Yeah. Like, wash that down with that. Oh, my God.
Oh, espresso and peanut butter?
It's like a thing.
Yes. Yeah. Instead of having a food pairing, we'll have a beer pairing.
Oh, yeah. That's great. Yeah.
What beer is that, Mike?
That's the Busted Knuckle.
Oh, yeah. Peanut butter.
Busted Knuckle is one of my favorites.
Yeah.
It's a good it's a good standard. It's a great standard. Right. I like the Quaffon, the Common Necessity.
Yeah.
I like the hazelnut.
Yeah, that's what he and I just had.
The Metazoa Slumber Party.
Yeah. Yeah.
Peanut butter
Slumber Party is.
You were to have the rest of this.
Most of the peanut butter ones are really, really extracty.
Yeah.
That's where it's so fake.
Yeah.
I don't know how Busted Knuckle actually does theirs with the peanut butter, but. It doesn't taste all that chemically.
Yeah. Have you ever had a DuClaw? Their Sweet Baby Jesus?
Yeah, yes. Yep. Sweet Baby Jesus. Yep.
That is one of my favorite beers in the world.
Is it really?
Oh, yeah. I love it.
I know Warren, yeah. Warren's
now,
a big
they have a Sweet Baby Java that is not very
good. It's not,
No.
Yep. No bueno.
No. I bought a six pack of it about a year ago, and five of those beers are still sitting in the band room.
No. It's been more than a year. It's been about 2 years ago.
Okay, yeah.
No, they are not.
Yeah, because it was at the. No, we threw them away when
they're
we were
in the trash
the
pile right now.
Yeah.
From
I still like the fact that my man down here is just he's drinking a nice old fashioned.
Yeah,
and that's always good.
What's
your favorite?
Wait, he is a bass player.
Whiskey, bourbon, or scotch?
This is a bourbon. But
okay,
I like bourbon and mixed drinks, but if I'm drinking straight, I want scotch.
Rye? Oh, scotch. Yeah. Sorry, yes. Do you like a peaty scotch or you?
Very much.
Oh,
I love Lafroig.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
It's probably my favorite. Oban and Lagavulin are close seconds. So,
If you get a chance, I know it's a mix, but the the Peat Monster by
Compass Box.
I'll have to check it out.
Well, it's got the most peat ever.
What's the name of the?
It's called Peat Monster.
Okay.
It's by Compass Box,
and it tastes like you're at a campfire.
It sounds like
my husband loves
character
Scotch
from
too.
Sesame Street that didn't get much screen time.
Yeah.
Peat Monster.
I thought it was just a gimmick. I never would have picked it up.
It smells like a peat bog.
It's like $24 a bottle,
but it's buttery. But it's buttery as hell. It goes down super smooth. It is a blend. But
well, my husband will have to try that.
Yeah,
whiskey gives me heartburn now because I'm old.
Really?
So
what?
I have to if I know I'm gonna have like red wine or whiskey, I have to take a Pepcid like an hour before, otherwise I can't.
Yeah, that's good.
It's funny. I don't drink much beer at the house anymore. I drink bourbon and scotch. If I'm out, I drink beer. You know, I don't drink much beer.
Vodka.
At the house anymore,
I am sorry that I'm. You know, drinking old fashioned beer.
We do liquor too. We're big on I was praising you.
Yeah,
I'm like
whiskey's a good thing.
Whiskey,
yeah.
Bourbons, we do it all. It's not just a beer show. That's why we do music. That's why we do craft foods. It's all local stuff and just trying to put that out there or the craft industry. That's something that's handcrafted a little bit more than just your standard macro big companies.
Hard to find craft scotch.
Yeah.
Especially if it's actual scotch.
Right.
You got to go across the pond to find
that. If you're going to find craft scotch, it's because, you can go over there. I'm sure there's some scotch that some guy's great-great-great-great-granddad made. It's sitting in a barn somewhere.
Oh, yeah.
Tell you what, most of those companies nowadays, though, have bought the land down both sides of the water source so that no one else can touch their water source.
Right, yeah.
Because they claim that is the source of the flavor.
Yeah.
Half the source beside the peat that they're burning, the water's the other part, so they'll buy all the land on both sides, so you're trespassing if you try to access the water that they use.
Yeah. When we went to Scotland in 2019?
Yeah. 19.
Yeah, the summer 19. Before the year that shall not be named. And we stopped at a distillery. It was in the lowlands. It was on the east-ish coast of Scotland. And they had only been in operation for about 3 years. So brand new distillery. Good whiskeys.
Mm-hmm.
I should take that back. They've have a 5-year scotch,
sure.
But the actual they've only been selling for three years. Anyway,
well, you
gotta
let it age. You can't,
something that I didn't think of is the fact that, and I knew this, but it didn't click, that whiskey, I mean, obviously you have to age it.
Right.
So even if you want to start a distillery, you got to wait minimum 5 years before you can sell that. So you're sitting
on
this. Most
scotches are 10 to 16.
Exactly, yeah.
Well, a baby is 10 years.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a,
so what, what I learned is that a lot of these scotch distilleries, and this is why there's a very large prevalence of gin in the UK, is because gin's super easy to make.
Right.
It's quick to make.
Yep.
So they make that to sell to support their scotch habit.
Yes. Yeah, most of them do.
So the gin that they had was amazing.
Amazing.
I bought a... brought a couple bottles back.
Oh, really?
The whiskey was, it
well,
was
that's,
new.
That's
it was
the
still
thing,
young.
And that's the problem. They're also now using whiskeys, unaged whiskeys, basically, to feed the scotch habit and while some other stuff ages, but they're still trying to sell some of it.
Yeah.
It's hooch. A lot of that
It's going to burn your nose hairs.
It burns, and it kind of sucks. But some of them are good, like the sweet, like a sweet corn whiskey is fine right out of the, you know, depending on how it's brewed or what it's brewed with. Or,
I'm usually really keen on the unaged stuff if you're mixing it with something.
Sure.
Yeah.
Because you could take that edge off. But
not straight. Yeah, yeah. It's those ones are good.
They're
for
not for
mixing.
Sipping.
No, not at all. Because there's nothing pleasant about those.
Yeah, we did this this distillery, and then it was I forget what it was called, but then we went to the Isle of Skye and did Talisker, which is hundreds of years old.
Yeah.
So it's like we're going from like the newest distillery in Scotland to one of the oldest.
The old, Yeah.
Right. So it was a definite
awesome.
Difference.
I don't think, at least here we don't talk about, you hear about drinkers, we think of the Irish and the Indian, but Scotland, those guys, I mean, they're drinking out of their frickin' sippy cups. I mean, Scotland drinks.
Yeah. Oh,
they drink,
they
and they're good drinkers.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, it's different. It is.
Yeah.
And you don't hear about, they always hear, you think of the Irish and the Germans drinking beer and the Irish drinking whiskey, but Scotland, and it's awesome that, the scotch that's so beautiful comes out, but you gotta think of there's so many years of history and those families are it's not diverse like going over here. I mean, it's those families have been doing that for centuries.
Yeah.
And so you get such a good product, but scotch is it's unique to people who aren't used to it, especially bourbon is completely different than scotch, and so it's a unique flavor to a lot of people who haven't had it. And sometimes take a little I love scotch. I love it.
I enjoy it. I just can't drink it unless I have a Pepsi.
Yeah. I remember we tried to walk a newly 21-year-old through a scotch tasting.
A scotch tasting.
How did that go?
It was fun.
It was fun for us.
For us. For you.
Did they vomit?
No, he didn't vomit.
He was good.
He sure didn't know what he was getting into. When their favorite drink is, Captain and Coke or something
red, white, and berry.
My first attempt at buying scotch, like I'd ordered it at restaurants and bars before. I'd gotten a big promotion at work, and I'm like, I'm going to splurge and buy a nice bottle of Lafroig. So I went in, they had a special reserve bottle, and I bought it and took it home and poured myself a glass, and it was terrible. And it was because I didn't know what cask strength was.
Oh, my God.
And I'm drinking cask strength scotch straight.
Oh, shit.
No
ice. You might
as
well used it
nothing.
As lighter fluid.
Yeah, that's basically was. It was evaporating before faster than I could drink it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yep. That'll learn you. And it just takes time. Just takes time.
Well, I just told Mel I have DeMars at home.
Brendan just snorting.
Should I hurry up and drink that and get rid of it?
Yeah.
Good, Maybe for Father's Day, we'll get you a good bottle of scotch.
Okay.
Mike, do you do scotch or bourbons?
I don't know anything about it, but yes, I drink it.
Apparently, he doesn't drink DeMars.
So if we put it in front of you, you'll drink it.
Yeah,
so Mikey likes it.
That's me.
I went to Florida and went to go visit my brother, and he had
the brother that he didn't talk to for weeks on end.
Yeah. And he had a bottle of scotch that was given to him as a gift. I don't even know what it was. It was good, though.
Right.
I enjoyed it a lot.
Awesome.
Like, it makes me want to be a scotch drinker, But I also know that bottle costs like $300.
Sure.
I can't afford that half. Yes.
You don't have to go that expensive, though. You can get a good bottle of scotch for
$40.
No,
you got to go around the Highlands. And you got to see what you like, too, because people those tastes
really they're so different.
They're so different between the regions.
Yeah, your lowland versus your Highlands versus your islands. Like, they're so different.
You can't try one.
I would say there's about four different varieties.
Yeah.
That's what I appreciate about craft anything, you know. Craft beer, craft coffee. It's like there's so much that goes into making it.
Sure.
People don't even realize.
Yeah. And it's just more and more now with all the we talk about the hops. The American hops are just bursting all over the place, and it's wild. You know, Germany is coming here to get hops from America to make German beer. And, how much the craft scene has boomed.
And when you said someone's talking about the water, even for the for that stuff, beer they do that too. Profile is big. You get a brewery down like Indiana City Brewing downtown. They actually they completely strip out the city water, and then they actually have the stuff to and the documentation, or at least the chemical analysis of waters from different regions. So if they're making a German beer, they can actually recreate the basic chemical profile of the water. So that's that kind of that uber nerd brewing stuff.
It's when you get a chemist along with a distiller.
But it's pretty cool that they're still able to take the city water, strip it out, and try to reassemble it at least.
Try to do that 100 years ago.
I know a lot of I know a lot of those places don't even purify the water first. They're like the process of making it will. It's kill anything that's in it.
Yeah.
So you're going to get all the sediment.
You go back to that centuries of doing that. And it's amazing.
Yeah. With beer, I had all of it pretty much written it off until I started getting into darker beers.
Yeah.
And then that just drew me right back in.
Sure.
And I don't know a lot about beer, but I can appreciate what goes into it because I know that it's I know a lot about coffee.
Yes, he does.
And like all the little nuances that people don't understand that makes the altitude that the plant was grown in, changes how its characteristics because it's oxygen starved if it's higher up, so it creates more of a more acidic,
right?
Because it's got to work harder to turn the light into food.
Photosynthesis.
That's kind of the same process for beer or even liquor.
Different
if
water.
If you're growing your hops in Seattle or that area as opposed to Indiana, it's going to, even if it's the same strain of plant,
completely
it's
going to
be
different.
So different. You have a different soil pHs. You have a different air content.
I think American hops are just kind of they keep finding new hops every other day, it seems like, because we do have so many different, it's awesome.
Man.
So, we got deep. Sorry there.
I didn't know my singer and my guitarist were.
Sorry there, Michonne.
I managed bars. I tasted alcohol for a living.
I know.
I do, too.
I drink coffee.
And I know my guitarist.
I don't anymore. Yeah.
The wife and I changed to a different coffee, and Mike said, "That's the gateway. You're going to be hooked now."
I drink Folgers Black Silk. He's ashamed of me.
That's what I used to drink.
Yeah, I like it.
I have
8 o'clock. Moved to 8 o'clock.
Folgers?
He just sneered.
I've actually roasted my own coffee before.
Did you burn the house down?
No. I used a hairdryer.
What? Did you take pictures of this?
I have a video. You should see this. I'll show it to you.
I'm not sure I want to use that hairdryer. Then that seems a really hot hairdryer.
I don't think I want to drink that coffee.
Something. Yeah,
I don't think Brandon and I have to worry about it
or watch the video for hair drying.
It was actually
beans. I don't know.
It was actually really good.
Awesome. Yeah. Interesting. I didn't know you could get them unroasted already.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
I've never. You can buy raw.
Yep.
Really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You can,
I mean, not at like Kroger. But you can get them.
Yeah. So. And the thing is, you can get it from specific farms, because one farm, tastes a certain way, and you can go 5 miles down the street, and then another farm will be different.
What?
Because it's even different on how they separate, how they separate the bean from the fruit changes how the coffee will taste.
It's coffee.
Yeah, there's Sean's like, it's coffee.
They'd be amazed.
Yeah, I know.
Kroger's not a farm.
That's right.
I get mine at Kroger.
Yeah. And I wouldn't expect someone who drinks Folgers to have any appreciation for the actual flavor of coffee.
I don't
like
drink Folgers.
Light drinker and beer.
You know what? You are correct. You know what I drink.
I know what you used to drink.
I used to drink Folgers, but I drink.
Yeah, yeah.
I just, drink
just like
clock.
You used to drink Coors now Light, and now you're drinking a Blue Moon.
Now he drinks Sanka. Now he has Sanka.
It's baby steps, man. Come on. Sanka.
So, all right, let me circle around here. Right. Back to the band. What we have coming up? We have a show on the 31st.
We do.
August 20th. If
literally
we're
at that
to talk
place,
about
Bar
it.
And Grill.
Yep, August 20th. We're playing at the famous.
Yes.
Melody Inn.
Yes.
Oh, there you go. Nice.
Just make sure your tetanus shots are up.
Should be a good crowd.
Yeah, Friday night.
Friday night.
So for all of my friends who complain that our shows are too late, if we play during the week, it's a Friday night. So get your ass
there.
There you go. Awesome.
Yeah, we're playing with, right now, they haven't named the third band, but the other band is Beautiful Trainwreck.
Very, very good band as well, yeah.
Good
band.
Awesome.
So.
Awesome.
More well-known than us, anyway. I mean.
Yeah.
Is that
saying much?
They got a video.
No, it's not.
They got a video. We don't have a video.
You guys can figure out how to video. You figured out how to, record yourselves now.
We've been,
so.
We've been playing a lot of shows in the recent past with Robots and Magic Powers.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And they're doing
that's
their own
other
videos
band, if you
now.
Guys
so.
Bring a band on.
Oh, it's a band. Okay.
Yeah, I thought
you meant. Never mind.
No.
The name of the band is Robots and Magic Powers.
They're very good band.
Very interesting. Very different.
Yep.
They don't follow the rules.
No,
so,
and it's good. Like
the,
it's in
those.
A good way. Right. Yeah.
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 So
look them up.
So like it's like a hard rock Pink Floyd.
Really?
There you go.
They're kind of a concept band. Like they have
lots of vocal effects.
Yeah. They have a theme about them, and it is in their name.
Yeah.
And the music is kind of centered around.
Got a keyboard player, bass player, guitar player, drummer,
and their persona on stage. Falls
good
out
band.
Personas.
Yeah.
They're all super nice.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
I haven't played with a lot of other bands that come up to me and hug me when they see us show up at a show. So.
Well, and they've even come to a couple of our shows that they weren't playing
at. That's nice.
Yeah.
Right. That's awesome.
Yep.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's good to have that kind of camaraderie in there. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I remember back in the day when the indie music scene used to be all about that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
There was still the cover band, original band competition shit going on.
Yeah, but,
so,
but I remember we used to, like me and the said brother, we used to go out every weekend and go catch bands.
Whether you knew them or not.
I remember back when I lived here before, my uncle was in the whole scene and growing up, and I think he was Coda and then Red Beans and Rice was a band he was in, always playing down in the Raskeller and Slippery Noodle.
Yep.
Yeah.
Slippery Noodle. Blues.
Yep. Yeah. You don't see that as much anymore. It does stink. You don't see that anywhere, not just here. I think that people have gone away from the local thing.
This may date me a little bit, but I remember going to shows to trade your demo cassettes, demo CDs with the other bands, and be like, hey, give these to people at your next show. We'll give people yours. Yep. And
I think some of the technology and
all the
internet stuff
we have,
though, it's
just,
it was
the original social networking.
Yeah,
sure.
Yeah. 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 I think that's what's great. You know, Indy In-Tune and place. Trying to still push that scene, because the scene is so vibrant and there's so many great people that you'll never see unless you won't see them.
Yeah. Yeah. I just hope this year of distance can be recovered.
Yeah.
Though that's what I'm waiting to see, because you have so many people that are going to get used, and even companies and all that of working from home and doing this, so everybody's very used to being apart.
But that also might start people for that interaction.
Yes, I am hoping. Some people super enjoyed it. They're like, oh, sweet, I'm not going to be around anybody.
I was not one of those people.
I think I can see both sides of it.
I definitely can.
I'm definitely on both sides of the coin, and that now when I go out, it's a bigger adventure.
Right.
I don't know.
Yeah.
It feels like a bigger deal to go have dinner now than it did.
Yeah, and I just hope people want to get back out, and it's not the separation that we've all had to experience.
Took a lot of stuff
for
granted that you didn't think you have to think about before. That no, I think like I said, I think you think about things more now. Even just going out to dinner, that just seemed like a nonchalant thing before. Now it's like, oh shit, I can actually go out to dinner.
Yeah.
It's an event.
It is. I mean, it's
Yeah. I think that's kind of always was like my hope, because before all of this. The music scene lived on the internet.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, people posted their stuff on Facebook,
right,
on
right.
Instagram, on YouTube, and people were getting famous off of that, too.
Right, and I think this may help people getting back out there again, wanting to go to see local shows.
So now that that's all that they've had and people have been stuck at home, hopefully people want to go out and do something different because that's all they had.
Right.
And maybe we'll see a surge in live music.
Absolutely.
I hope so.
That'd be nice.
Well, yeah. You can start July 31st, go see Red Remains. And
there you go.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Absolutely. Wow, we had feedback for the first time.
And it'll be one of our longer shows. We will literally be playing every song we know.
It all depends.
And then some.
And then some. We're learning a couple new
covers
for this.
As long as no one dies on us. Is that where you were going?
No, this time just keep going.
Yeah, as long as you don't kill someone.
You're the one who's going to kill
people. They call 911. Can
someone drag him outside so we can keep going?
We don't need a drummer. It's fine.
I would never actually do that.
I'm kidding. We love you, Sean.
What? That's all right.
What did I miss?
We have to love you.
He can play the organ now and drum beats and drum machines. And
we'll talk about him playing an organ on practice day.
It was Casio. It was Casio or whatever. What was the old? Yeah.
That's what he calls it.
Casio, it's its name.
All right. Thank you. Thank you guys for coming out. Had a great conversation.
Awesome.
Good beers.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you. Go see Red Remains.
Yes.
Check out the websites for the upcoming shows, or listen here and put it in your calendar.
Do both.
Do it all. exactly.
Great.
You know, whatever works. And awesome. We'll be back again for another show.
Cheers, guys.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks.
See ya.